Flowers have always fascinated us with their unique beauty and enticing scents. People thought flowers had magical powers. In the 17th century in the Netherlands, there was a real craze for the beautiful tulips, and they became more expensive than gold. But flowers aren't just beautiful to look at. They have been used for medicinal purposes, making colors and dyes, and even for food. The reason for this splash of colors in nature is that without flowers, plants cannot reproduce. It's the beautiful colors of the flower that attract insects and birds to steal its nectar. They help in a process called pollination. Here is a hibiscus flower. Let us study the different parts of the flower. The outermost part is called the sepal. It is usually green in color and looks like a leaf. The sepals protect the flower when it is a developing bud. The next part is the most attractive and colorful. This is called petal. In some flowers, the petals are separate, while in others, the petals are fused to look like one petal. At the center of the flower, we find the male and the female parts. Most plants have both these parts in the same flower. The male part is called the stamen. It is made up of an anther, which is supported by a long filament. The pollen is produced in the anther. Pollen is necessary for the formation of seed. The female part of the flower is called the pistil. It is made up of stigma, style, and ovary. The stigma is usually hairy or sticky to trap the pollen grains. The style connects the stigma to the ovary. The ovary, which is shaped like a capsule, is located at the base of the flower. It contains the ovules or the eggs. Just outside the ovary, nectar is produced. Nectar is a sugary liquid that attracts the insects and the birds to the flower. Pollination leads to the fertilization of ovules, which develop into seeds. The different parts of the flower work towards the formation of seeds.